Shutdown complete. Vital signs stable. Activating various suit. Suit diagnostic complete. All systems functional. Command interface enabled. Requesting new heading. Course leading. Fighters approaching. Incoming transmission.
Unidentified vessel, please switch to secure radio frequency and transmit your identity code. We are standing by. Transmission verified. Greetings, Samus. We welcome you on behalf of the Galactic Federation. Proceed to the command ship Olympus. You've been cleared for docking bay 5. Welcome back, Samus.
Calibrate your weapon by shooting these targets. Calibration complete. Samus, welcome to the flagship Olympus. Admiral Dane is waiting for you in the briefing room. I will upload the location to you now.
Hey Samus, these walkway mechanisms aren't working. Something must be jamming the gears.
Thanks, Samus.
Thank you. Azon Enhancement Device, GFDF-PX013. The Phazon Enhancement Device is based on captured space pirate technology. It is being tested by a GF Marine Battalion stationed in the Norian system. Marines can initiate an energy siphon from a supply of Phazon carried in a backpack into their armor suits. This allows them to temporarily enhance the exoskeletal and weapon systems of their armor suits. To date, no Marines have displayed signs of Phazon sickness, common in subjects who use the Space Pirate's version of the system. Aurora Unit GFDF AU-068. 20 years ago, a team of Federation scientists announced the birth of an organic supercomputer. Its name was Aurora. Since that historic date, thousands of Auroras have been built and installed. Originally designed for scientific purposes, the Auroras are now used in government, business, and military roles as well. They are given male, female, or gender-neutral personas based on the needs and desires of the staff in the facility they are to serve in. A vast network links all existing Auroras, allowing them access to a tremendous database without peer. GFS Olympus, GFDF BB063. The first of its class, the GFS Olympus was launched 18 years ago from the Federation shipyard at Aetius 3. Aurora Unit 242 has been on board since launch, the first AU to serve aboard a capital ship. Olympus is the flagship of the 7th Fleet. Her home port is planet Norian. Admiral Castor Dane has commanded the vessel for the last 5 years. Planet Norian, GFDF-NN-088. Though located on the fringe of the Federation, the planet Norian is of great importance. The military maintains a strong presence in the sector, and the base on Norian is often the first line of defense against enemies that operate outside of GF space. Originally a barren orb incapable of sustaining life, a sophisticated terraforming project designed by Aurora Unit 486 has turned Norian into a hardy forest world. Access granted.
Try not to move during the procedure. We need a stable.
I understand the procedure.
Subject is clear for the command bridge.
You may proceed.
Of course.
You'll need to pull that lever to warp you to enter the containment area.
Security lockdown. Prisoner transfer schedule.
Please step into the containment area to begin the security scan. Initiating DNA verification. DNA verified. Registration number 13576. Identified as Bounty Hunter Samus Aran. Preparing biohazard scan. Please approach the scan terminal. Scan complete. No hazardous material detected. Samus, you are cleared for the command bridge.
Thank you. me to remind you that suit maintenance and data backup should be done before the meeting. There's a recharge station at the other side of the walkway.
Andrea, enough! Looks like everyone's here now. Before I begin the briefing, let me introduce 242, the flagship's Aurora unit.
Ah, an organic supercomputer. Fascinating. It's my understanding that the Galactic Federation's core network is comprised of such units.
That is correct, Core. And we serve as the network's master control. However, currently the network is down.
That seems inefficient.
But necessary. You see, 7 days ago, we discovered that all Aurora units were infected with an unknown virus. We were forced to bring the network down. Fortunately, our scientists were quickly able to devise a vaccine.
Unit 242 was the first AU to receive the vaccine. We were able to completely purge the virus.
Where did this virus come from?
We believe the virus is of space pirate origin. 4 months ago, the GFS Valhalla went missing while on a training mission in the Klar Nebula. The ship's logs revealed that they were attacked by a space pirate raiding vessel.
What is the logic in disrupting a Federation training mission?
They're pirates. How could they resist a prize like that?
That never would have happened if I'd been there.
Then it's a shame you weren't. The pirates boarded the Valhalla and gained access to the ship's Aurora unit, 313. This is how they were able to hack into the network and plant the virus.
Thanks to our security protocols, we were able to shut down the network before the damage to the virus became irreversible.
But we're still vulnerable. If the pirates decide to launch a major offensive, we'd be hard-pressed to defend ourselves. We must rid the other AUs of that virus and bring the network back online. That's where you come in. We need you to deliver the vaccine to each of the AUs in this system. We'd also like you to investigate the pirates' activity in the area. We need to know what they're up to.
Condition red. All personnel to combat-ready stations. Repeat. Condition red.
Sir, a space pirate attack fleet has just warped out of some sort of wormhole. They're also heading for Sector Zero, the planet's home base.
No! They're targeting the planetary defense system. Get down to the planet and aid the ground troops. Stop those pirates from disabling the defense system. Go!
Get to your ship.
need you down on the planet. Until we get the fleet in formation.
Thank you. Thank you.